legal packs, if there is a legal packs, if there are legal packs then there are wages there that I was supposed to say, so that they just make sure they collect the siblings out. You need to comply with
good morning, Steve. How are you? Are you prepared to come back to the community and the outcomes of what you, in the understanding that there is something going on here that's illegal and needs to be rectified?
I'm not listening.
Are you happy as our representative to go forward and then come back to the community with the outcomes and with what is delivered and changed about this situation?
I can't say now. What I say is, if there is
on the
people, if people are not complying, they have to accept it. That's what I'm saying. The laws in there, and a lot of this, and I don't stand by the fact that you've got to lock everything up. That's why we have unsustainable areas now. That's why we've got unsustainable supplies. Every timber mill will tell you that they are getting there to deliver the guaranteed wood supply agreement. They are chopping smaller and smaller trees down, which means that instead of recutting in 5 years, they were going back in 15 years.
I understand what's happening and what's not happening. The question is, I'm just asking, in the understanding, if there is something illegal going on here, and I'm only here as a community member to find out for myself if that is the case, as we all are, but now that we're informed and we go to Forest and see it for ourselves, and then we're all sort of charged with that responsibility now to take action if that is the case, because if there's an illegal thing happening, whether it's shoplifting or whatever else it is, then as our representative, are you happy to come back to us as the community to report to us as to what changes and what you've implemented and what you put forward to the rest of the government to change the situation?
There is no change needed. What there needs is, if there is compliance and regulations in there now...
The organisation that administers this, because right now they've admitted that they're not able to do so.
If there's an issue there and they've been aware of it, It's not like they haven't got two compliance officers that can come in and check it out.
They've admitted that they're unable to administer it as such, so therefore an outcome might be to refund that body properly so that they're in a position to stand by State Forest and see tree by tree which trees are coming down and whether it falls legally or illegally. It's as simple as that. There's a possible outcome. Otherwise it's quite political hogwash again. A pre-election, I question whether you can afford that.
I'm not promising nothing. Except that if you're not complying, they have to comply. You've got compliant officers there, they should be there. They should be there to do their job. And that's what I'm saying. Now, if that's what you want, that's what you want to really hear, that's what I'm saying, because I believe if it's illegal, then get the compliance officers in there to stop it. If it's not illegal and they're just carrying out their jobs...
You're happy as our representative to go forward and in the understanding of what's happening here and to report back to us on the outcome of that or not. Doesn't matter.
Look, I'm happy to, but let me say this. You vote where you want to vote. I'm not here to say yes to everybody here. Because I think everyone here would love no longer. Many people were like, what I'm saying here is that I support sustainable logging.
Yeah.
I really believe. And
can we have a hand count, please? Who supports sustainable logging?
And let me also say this too, that Bob Carr, in my opinion, went way too far, locking up everything he could lock up, and then making that same guarantees for the forestry to deliver unsustainable.
They identified a level of resource that could be met with a level of protection, right? Now,
they cannot possibly say they guaranteed a level of resource that could be met.
They overestimated. But the point is, the process was they identified a level of resource that could be provided, and we got what was left into conservation reserves. But we also got
way too much.
But there's enough there to provide.
They
can't find the timber that they committed to.
Bob Carr overestimated. I'm sorry. Guys, I'm going to take this man to hospital. That's why I'm here very shortly. I've got to go to two meetings. I'm happy to talk, and I'm happy to cop this talk. But let me say this. I know it, and so is all the forest locked up.
This is about
National Park. And it's not even, they can't even manage what they've locked up. and that's the sad thing.
Both ways.
So there should be more funding.
Both sides.
Could I give you the briefing notes anyway? And that one deals with what the timber commitments are and what they're actually getting out of the log. Because they've overcommitted the timber, they can't meet the resource requirements, and that's costing us money because we're having to compensate the mill for timber that doesn't exist and didn't exist in the first place because it was overestimated and overcommitted.
The whole agreement was a locking up, sham and committee, overcommitting with limited resources.
That's in your opinion.
They asked, is the National Party favourable as a policy that actually mentions the word forest? The policy, 60-page of policy booklet that's been produced on regional New South Wales doesn't even mention the word forest. It's a major issue.
It's a major issue in all timber communities.
Exactly.
In all timber communities as well. Do we release a policy on opening up national parks? No, we don't. And we won't.
But we don't know, because it's not
there. But we realise that this is one of the most biodiverse regions in Australia, and yet we have one of the most inadequate reserve systems in Australia compared to all the other states. In terms of forests, our reserve system is the worst, right? Conservative government, everything all over the years.
But the reserve system isn't working because they've locked everything up.
No, no, but we have less reserve here, proportionally, than the other states in terms of our forests, you know. We are a very rich, important area for biodiversity. It's really important we maintain that. The best way to maintain that is
through reserves. We have less reserves because we've locked most of the forests up into national parks.
Reserves are national parks, right?
No, not reserves. We have to let reserves in available to be cut. It will not be cut in action.
The point I'm trying to make is that we are on a national scale.
Love to talk to you. About standing borders. We're talking the same, but we're talking different. This here, I'm happy to read.
Good.
I'm happy to read, and I will read.
And I'm sorry you won't come up to the forest now. We can show you where they've been logging illegally. I'm disappointed.
I was up there for 15 minutes, so I was given the wrong direction, so I was up there waiting for everyone 15 minutes.
I'm just sorry we can't get you up there to show you what we... The proof. Where's the proof is there?
Well,
the New South Wales government's been lying again about logging of the endangered ecological communities. They're saying it's not happening. The proof is there waiting for
you. You support them with your... Your
preference in
the last election?
Me, I'm not a conservationist, so I give my preferences.
Thank you very much.
Best.
See you all later.
Bye
bye. When you speak up for the forest, some of you have grown. I mean, I am. Why is that a bad thing? Well, but I am a greener, I'm proud to be, but I mean, other people speak
He's big trouble if he labels us all as one.